So, both of these setups, one's a setup to the golf ball, one's a practice swing. They look pretty similar in terms of where the golf ball is or the club is in relation there to kind of your legs there, the hands are in front of your body. You all look facing the camera, yeah?
Yeah.
That was good. So you make a lovely practice swing. Great position there. Really, really good. Let me bring the golf club back to the golf ball. We're still facing the golf ball here. Now my camera's not moving, obviously in the same position. You put the golf club down, and as we said, for some reason, decide to sort of shuffle your feet, keep moving around there. And now if you get to set up here, okay, we zoom out there and see them there. You'll know how much distance you've got from there to there. You just move around this way for some reason. You move around the edge of the mat. The golf ball now is perceived to be further forward because you just move around this way. Okay. Yeah. The shaft, the club, if we sort of put a line through the golf club there, that's kind of the angle of your golf club there, off to the side there, where that's the angle of your golf club kind of there. You just move around there. So you're going to be catching the ball now as the club works too far around to the left, as it's going to catch the toe end and just scut off the side. Exactly, yeah. So we look at the impact of these now, as you hit this golf ball, the blur and the golf balls, we can see the blur of the golf balls beneath the blur of the driver, whereas this one now, because you're more in line with the golf ball, let me go back there.
Oh, right.
I'll go back one frame. There you go.
Yes.
See the contact? So the driver now and the blur are kind of in line, where if we put the club there, the ball's under it. So that golf ball is whatever that gap is there, underneath the middle of the club. So you're losing power. That's a much more powerful hit, hence why they're going further. And this swing here now finished more of your left shoulder, whereas that one is that left foot. Look at the left foot.
That's flat again.
You've got the left foot jumping away. Trying to swing through, left foot jumped away. Look at your left foot on this one, on the right. Stay in the same spot, you see. You're rotating around your left foot a lot better. Much more efficient, more powerful shot.
Pretty good a bit there. That's not bad, you know.
If we look at that there, and we'll just say, right, that one's a no-no, but that one's a yes.
Yeah.
Okay? Because that's a good swing. That's much more movement around your left foot. You're rotating around your left foot, and you're facing the golf ball. You're hitting the golf ball there, not kind of as a glancing blow. All your energy was going to the left before, catching in the golf and the ball then goes, and that's probably why you started aiming a bit left, because a couple of shots got off the toe were scuttling to the right. So in your heading, if I just aim a little bit further left, it might not go quite so far right. But the more left you aim, the more the toe of the club you're going to strike it, the more weak the shot's going to be. Vicious
circle. 10th hole on the mat.
Yeah, so all the sort of sheeped up on the right hand side, yeah?
Yeah, when it goes further than that.
So we can get yourself in a setup position there now where you're rotating around your spine, a much more direct hit to target. That there's sort of a telltale sign, the middle of the club now, in the middle of the blur of the ball, are in line, and a much fuller swing there to balance. The left foot was still, that left foot, you watch your left foot there, you're jumping away and we're dancing, yeah.
Okay, let me see if I can do three consecutives.
Go for it. Okay.